So today, I am talking about a football team that, in my opinion, has some of the most rabid fans
of any football team in the United States.
And honestly, I learned a whole lot doing this list and have really enjoyed finding out more about this team. I'm doing this list today because of a request from Megan. If you have a request, tell me the subject and I will find 13 facts that you probably didn't know. You can either leave the request in the comments or give it to me on my social medias if you know them. Today I bring you 13 facts about the Green Bay Packers that you probably didn't know. Number one, near the end of the 1967 championship game against the Dallas Cowboys, the Packers were down by 3 points. They could have tied it up with a field goal and possibly won in overtime, but this was not any ordinary game. It was actually the coldest football game ever played in NFL history, and the wind chill was said to be less than negative 70 degrees Fahrenheit, and coach Vince Lombardi had had enough. Reportedly, Vince Lombardi told his quarterback, Bart Starr, run it. Let's get the hell out of here. They did a quarterback sneak, winning the game. This decision has been called the gutsiest move in NFL history. Number two, when it comes to professional sports, the owner of the team is generally very wealthy, and it's one person who owns the team. This is one thing that separates the Green Bay Packers from any other sports team. They are in fact owned not by one person, but an entire community. Number three, in 1996, the Green Bay Packers were in the playoffs, and their defensive end Hall of Famer Reggie White engaged in something that people today are calling smash for cash. He essentially rewarded his own teammates with stipends out of his own pocket every time they would tackle an opposing player successfully. The sums of money that he'd give out reportedly amounted to up to $500 a tackle, and needless to say, his teammates were probably inspired to play a little harder. What he was doing wasn't illegal, but people definitely raised their eyebrows. But when playoff times come around, as they say, you do what you gotta do to keep your team inspired in this case. Number four, the Green Bay Packers were initially founded in 1919 by newspaper editors Curly Lambeau and George Whitney Calhoun. Lambeau was the Packers' first head coach. And interestingly enough, the founders knew each other in high school. They actually played on rival football teams. Number five, if you've ever wondered how the Packers got their name, here it is. When the team was founded, they needed funds to purchase uniforms. There was a company called Indian Packing Company who decided to help them out. They gave the team $500 to purchase uniforms, with the only condition being that the team would be named after their company, thus giving birth to Green Bay's iconic team name, the Packers. Number six, the population of Green Bay, Wisconsin is approximately 105,000 people. That makes Green Bay the smallest city to host an NFL team. Number seven, quarterback Aaron Rodgers is a hero to many Packers fans. He's not at all afraid to let it be known what his favorite movie is. That is The Princess Bride.
Kind of makes him a hero to me too. I mean, just saying. Probably my second favorite movie of all time. My favorite being The Goonies. Number eight. Another fun fact about Aaron Rodgers. The San Francisco 49ers could have got him. And then the list I would have done earlier this year, which was about the Chiefs because they won the Super Bowl, it may have been about San Francisco. Just saying. Number nine. One more Aaron Rodgers fact. He prefers his footballs to have more air in them. So kind of the opposite of Deflategate, except he's not breaking any NFL rules. So do you remember when Coca-Cola started putting names on the bottles of Coke? One of the funniest memes that I've ever seen in my entire life had the name Brady on a bottle of Coke, and the caption on the meme said, "Tastes flat." It's funny stuff right there. Number 10. Are you interested in getting season tickets to Packers games? Well, you'll be waiting quite a while. The current wait time for season tickets is about 40 years. Number 11. Randall Cobb, a former member of the Packers, has amazing work ethic when it comes to his schooling. Very, very impressive. Cobb left Kentucky in his junior year, but was determined to finish his degree. During the first week of training camp, Cobb was also preparing for an online final. Sadly, he plays for the Cowboys now. I mean, Maybe he's afraid of tornadoes. And the safest place to be during a tornado is the Cowboys end zone, because there's never a touchdown there. See what I did there? Number 12. Lambeau Field, or the frozen tundra as it's often called, does occasionally get warm. The warmest game in the history of Lambeau Field was on September 24th, 2017, when it was 89 degrees at kickoff against the Bengals. The Bengals lost the game. What a surprise. And number 13, the term cheesehead was originally an insult to Packers fans because Wisconsin produces a lot of cheese. Well, the fans embraced this name, and the first film cheesehead was worn in 1987. Apparently, the Chicago Bears are as good at insulting the Green Bay Packers fans as they are at winning Super Bowls. I mean, they had one back in 1985. One thing that the Bears are really good at is being mentioned on Saturday Night Live skits.
Absolutely.
This year, the Bears are playing.
And look forward to the many games the Bears will be playing 300 years from now.
The Bears.
The Bears.
So I hope you enjoyed this list of facts about the Green Bay Packers. How many of them did you not know? Let me know in the comments. If you like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you hadn't subscribed to my channel yet, you can go ahead and do that if you'd like. And tell all your friends. I hope your day is amazing and that you keep being kind to one another.